So we started, we completed till the RBP guys. From there, the next step is going to be configuring your objects. And as mentioned, these are the four different types of objects that are available in your employee central system. And your foundation object is nothing but any object. In fact, as I mentioned earlier in your success factors, it is nothing but a group of fields combined together and their associated properties. Okay, nothing but their structures which constitute different fields and the properties of those fields. Okay, and your foundation objects, coming to the foundation objects, your foundation objects are going to be build the required structures to capture your organization structure, whether your legal entity, your business unit, or your location, division, department. All these things are going to be built using this foundation object, guys. I mean, the structures provided by the foundation objects. Whereas your employee central, and one second, guys. And how your foundation objects are going to be usually related is, like, you have a legal entity or a company. Even in SuccessFactors, it's called the legal entity, guys. And below that, you can see a couple of business units. Hold on, just a second, guys. You have a legal entity, nothing but your company, and below that you can see a couple of business units. Okay, and each business unit can have again couple of divisions, and below your divisions you can see some departments. And if you have the financial system, you might have cost centers as well. And when you talk about your geographical, you can have a geo zone, and below the your geo zone, sorry guys, you can have some location groups, and below your location groups you see the actual location, guys. So all these entities, whatever I mentioned here, they are part of your foundation objects. And just for your information, all these foundation objects are going to be built using your corporate data model, guys. Okay, so ideally I can say the foundation objects are provided by the corporate data model. Okay, so all these things comes from your corporate data model. Okay, so when you talk about, so you have a legal entity, you have business unit, and let me put it down all these things, guys. I'll send you these notes. You have a business unit and you have the division, department, your cost centers, geo zone, and location groups. Location, sorry. Okay, your legal entity, at a high level, your legal entity is going to store nothing but, as I told you, these are the structures, right? They will help you to store or to capture the data to create a company in your SuccessFactors employee central system. So let me show you on the system how it looks like. If you go to your admin tools, and your legal entity cannot span across, it is going to bounded to a particular country, guys. Each country should go, usually should go with a one, at least, like, if you have multiple country implementations, each country should have one legal entity. And let me show you that fields, how the fields are going to come up. Manage org. Yeah, you can see this is the administrative option that we need to use to create any of these entities, guys. Whatever the foundation object, these are the different foundation object entities that we can create, right? So in order to create these things, say if you want to create or have a look at the existing legal entities of your organization, you can see manage organization pay and job structure, the administrator option. Click on that.
Raghu, Sunil here.
Yeah, Sunil.
From here?
Yeah, I'm able to hear. Tell me, Sunil.
Can I continue from here?
Yeah. This is where we started, Sunil. Yesterday we completed the RBP, right? This is where we started the foundation
object. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, 1 second.
Guys. Raghu, where can we find this manage or pay and job structure in the admin? Not in the way you find this object, I mean these things, but in the process. You can find that somewhere in the manage. Go to your employee files.
Yeah, you can see in the employee files, manage org pay and job structures. As your legal entity, if you notice, guys, when I started in 1505, I mentioned that these are migrated to MDF foundation objects. Your MDF foundation objects are going to be maintained. The data of those things are going to be maintained using this manage data option, guys. You see the manage data option. Use this administrative tool option, manage data. And let me show you a couple of existing legal entities. So say if you are interested in looking at the existing legal entities, so you are interested in legal entity, select the legal entity as your object. And these are the existing legal entities. Let's say I am interested in looking at the legal entity with the name ACE_USA. You see, let me select one of those things, guys. You see here, this is your legal entity. You have, see, your, this is one of the legal entity record, and the fields that captures or that constitutes the legal entities, these are the things. You see here, for country, United States, and what is the status? Okay, all these things, your legal entity, you see here, these things are going to come up here, and you have a relationship between your company legal entity and your business unit, and that is the reason you can see when you're trying to create a new company code or a legal entity, you can associate that with a business unit. I'll talk about these associations probably in tomorrow's session. Go ahead, guys.
Okay, so this business unit is kind of a business area, Raghu, like in SAP. Company code, we have business areas under
Correct.
The okay. Yeah. And what is this wheel ID and wheel name and all those things?
No. It has been customized, Nitin.
Yeah. Somebody has changed that just like that.
Yeah. We can do that. Oh. We have the configuration workbook. We need to do all those changes, Nitin.
Okay. Go ahead. Sorry.
Hey, no worries. Okay. So in the same fashion. Say if I want to create a brand new legal entity, I am searching for the existing legal entities using this left hand side search option. But say if I want to create a new legal entity, I can go ahead and search, yes, I want to create a new legal entity, and the fields that are going to be captured, we can configure these fields, guys. What fields needs to be captured when you are creating a new legal entity, which fields needs to be mandatory, which can be optional, what are their properties, all these things we can capture, guys. You see here, this is how I'm going to create a new legal entity. I have to populate these values here, and this is going to create a new legal entity for me. Okay, and coming to the next one, the business unit. And this business unit is going to store the, usually it is going to store all the operating units of a particular, of any organization, guys. Or a company, and one business unit is going to constitute one operating unit in your organization, and again your business unit. Let's say you see here, if you want to create a new business unit, you can create a new business unit record from this. And remember guys, we are creating the data, we are not customizing the structure. You are creating the records, the legal entity or your business unit records here. And the customization goes with a different tool, guys. I'll show you that in a minute. And you can see all these are the different existing business units in our system. Okay, and your divisions, departments are going to be built, your department and your division, you see here, and your cost center, you see here, cost center, and your location. One second, location might be still in one second guys. Yeah, location is I guess still it in the corporate data model guys. I mean to say it's not migrated to MDF foundation objects. Give me a second, I'll confirm on that guys. Here, go to manage org pay and job structures. Yeah, you can see location still under your corporate data model, or it is in the foundation objects, it's not migrated to your corporate the MDF foundation objects guys. You can see all these are the different locations that has already been captured in our instance. Okay, let's say Atlanta, or let me show you what are the fields. Remember guys, when you talk about MDF, to manage the data we went to the manage data administrator option, and if they are not migrated to your MDF platform, you are going to maintain the data using this manage organization pay and job structures. Minor difference guys, earlier we used to have everything under the manage organization pay and job structures. As they are migrating that to MDF foundation objects, we have a couple of things here in your corporate data model foundation objects, and couple of things under your metadata framework foundation objects guys. You can see this is your location, and there is a relationship between your location and your legal entity. Okay, so that is how guys. Otherwise
Raghu, can you explain that once again?
Yeah, sure, I'm going there. See, if you take any release before 1505, one second, prior to B1505 release, we have all these foundation objects, the whatever that I mentioned, the above, the complete list is part of your, the complete foundation objects is part of your corporate data model, and you are going to maintain the data of these corporate data model foundation object entities using this manage org pay and job structures administrative option. And to customize these foundation objects, we have to rely on your corporate data model XML file. Okay, any change will go into the corporate data model. But with 1505, starting B1505 release, your foundation, couple of entities that are existing under the foundation objects, especially your legal entity, your business unit, division, department, cost center, these has been migrated to a metadata framework, and they have been called as metadata framework MDF foundation objects. Okay, and in order to maintain the data or the records of these type of entities, we go to the administrative option of manage data, If you want to create a new legal entity, you go to the manage data and you select for the legal entity and you start populating the data or creating the records. And to customize this MDF foundation objects, we have an administrative option called as configure object definition. Guys, I'll confirm on this once. Just give me a second. Configure object definition is the administrative tool, guys. You don't need to rely on for these kind of objects, no XML file changes, guys. We don't need to do any XML file changes. It can be completely customized from your instance itself using this configure object definitions, guys. Okay, this is the customization option to customize MDF foundation objects, and the same option to customize your generic objects as well, guys.
So Raghu, I have a small question here. This is Nitin. Okay, for the prior to 1505 year, using corporate data model is the requirement, right? To load.
That's the only option to load your foundation objects.
Correct. And after 1505, you are telling that that is not required for some of the objects.
Correct.
So that means corporate data model is not required for some of the objects, but for some of the objects,
yes,
we require corporate data model, right?
Correct.
So SAP will automatically remove these objects from the corporate data model, or it will give in both the options basically. Right?
No. In 1505, what happened was, in 1505, yet it is there because it is transitioning, right? It is there, okay, in the XML file in as both, well. But okay, what okay. They did is like they did a universal upgrade. It's not an option opt-in future. But what they did is like in the instance, whenever you go to the manage organization page job structures, right? Whenever the movement is like legal entity, the system will determine, yes, the legal entity has been migrated to MDF foundation objects. It will automatically redirect you to the manage data option.
Got you. But so that basically, yes, okay. The file, the data model will be same. Only some of the objects will move to metadata foundation, and the system knows that basically.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. And so my question is like, we have no option to maintain now legal entity in the corporate in the manage pay or pay
no, or no. We don't have that option, Nitin. We cannot do that.
Okay, thanks Raghu, go ahead.
Okay, and so this is the configure object definition. Is slight difference, guys. We are configuring the structure, we are defining the structure, the properties of the fields inside your object. We are going to configure them using this configure object definitions. If you see here, I selected the object definition on the search side. You see here, object definition, and I want to look at the what are the fields currently being used to capture your legal entity. Click on this legal entity. All the other things are country specific entities, guys. You don't need to worry about that at this moment. I'll talk about that in a minute. You see here, all these are the fields and their associated properties. If you open any of those fields, let's say if you are interested in looking at the details, click on this details. You see the field name and its associated the technical ID, external name, the what is the maximum that it can hold, and there should be you can see visibility, editable, or it is only read only, or it is going to be hidden. Okay, all these things, the status is active, which means that we are using that field. And you can see the label, this is what it is going to be displayed on the screen. So someone is asking the wheel, why it is showing as wheel. Let's say if I want to change it to, not this here, guys. So if I want to change these things, click on make correction. And if you go to the external name, click on this details. Let's say I want to keep it as legal entity name. We have a configuration workbook for these changes, so these sort of changes, configuration changes, we'll follow that, guys, to do all those requirements. Click on done, and it is being now displayed as legal entity name. You can see nothing but the field definitions and their associated properties, and you have the associations.
Raghu, this is Paresh.
Yes, sir.
No, sir. Yeah. It is like a, what we this property which you are showing is like a in SAP HR or when we are going F1 technical help, it is like a domain name and data element. It is the same thing.
No, it's not help. One second, yeah. A sort of like it's not something when you click on F1, you'll be able to see those details, right? But this is the configuration, the backend configuration. Say if you go to data dictionary, right? In SAP, if you go to data dictionary and if you want to look at the properties of a table or a structure, you'll put the structure name and when you open that, right, you'll be able to see this is the ID of that particular field and what the data that it can hold, what type of data that it can hold, and what is the maximum length of the data it can hold. Those kind of details we are going to configure under this configure object definition.
Yeah, that is what I mean. Whether we go to SE11 and see the data table definition.
Correct.
That was it. That was it. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. We'll configure those things here, but I'm just showing you the difference between how you are going to populate the data or the records or how you are going to configure the object itself. Okay. This is the customization ops tool that we are going to use, configure object definitions. And you're going to maintain the data using this manage data administrate manage data option, guys.
Raghu, Sunil here.
Yes, Sunil.
Is it possible to repeat the same thing if it's possible?
Yeah, sure. One second. Yeah, I know like there will be a little bit of confusion here. See, one thing is populating data or the records. So for that, if it is if still the objects are part of your corporate data model, you have to use the manage arc pay and job structure option to create these records. But if it is part of it is migrated to MDF foundation objects, you have to use the manage data option. Okay. And say coming to the configuration side, you're populating the records as an end user. Just let me finish this, guys. Can you just hold on for your question for a minute? So the next thing is going to be you have to configure the structure itself or you have to configure the object itself. So for that, if it is part of your still the object is part of your corporate data model, you have to work on the XML file, your corporate data model XML file, and you have to load that into your provisioning system. Okay, and if it is part, if it is migrated to MDF foundation objects, you can use configure object definition and this can also this is in your instance itself, guys. You don't need to look at your provisioning account to do these changes. Is that clear, Sunil?
Somewhat.
It's pretty simple, guys. One is you are populating the data. End users are the your HRs might be HR generalist or someone might be populating your legal entities. They are creating a couple of legal entities or departments, divisions. That is nothing but you are populating the data or creating a new records for these type of entities. These are the different foundation object entities, right? But you have to configure. See, as a consultant, you have to configure these things, right? What fields needs to be constitute your legal entity in your organization. Say a client A can have 10 fields to capture the legal entity of their organization. Client B can have 20 fields to capture the legal entity of their organization. So each client have their own fields to define a legal entity or any of these entities. So that you are going to configure the object itself. And for that configuration, if it is part of corporate data model, which is not migrated yet, you have to do the changes in your XML file. You'll be a little bit more clear when you start configuring, guys. But you can see if they are migrated to MDF foundation objects, you have to use the configure object definition administrative tool in your instance itself to configure those objects.
So you're going to work on one as an example?
Yeah, we'll work on both the ways of doing the changes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Raghu, as far as the organizational structure is concerned, how do you create the organization structure in SuccessFactor?
Yeah.
I mean, if you go in the SAP HR, I mean, of course, you use Nakisa or some other tool to create the structure.
Yeah. I'll show you how you are going to create the architecture. You will be able to see that when we are building these associations between the different types of entities or objects here, Rajiv.
Okay, and then the MDF Foundation. I mean, how often do you'll have to create these objects through MDF?
No, it's a one-time configuration. During the time of your project implementation, you'll be doing this. After that, okay. If you have any enhancements, you'll carry out that. But usually, it is more of like a one-time activity during the time of your project implementation, Rajiv.
Okay. So if you have new fields, you need to add new fields, those with enhancements, correct?
Yes. What we'll be doing, right now you have seen the foundation object, right? Let me finish this employment object, personal object, generic objects. Then we'll start configuring those objects, guys. Populating data anyone can do, but your configuration goes, or you should know what the configuration, all these things, guys. And
right, Raghu, just one quick question on this one. As you said before, 1505, if you had to customize anything, it would be done through an XML file, but now it's done through the instance itself. And you were talking about that, you said that there were only few foundation objects which were migrated. You have told us that these were transferred. Which ones are not?
GeoZone, location, group, location are not migrated yet to your MDF foundation objects or the MDF platform. You can easily identify, guys. If you go to your instance and if you search in the manage data, or if you go to manage org and page job structure, if you don't find that over there in the manage org and page job structure, which means that it is migrated to MDF foundation objects. To populate the records in MDF foundation objects, you can go to the manage data. Let's say I don't know whether a particular object has been migrated to MDF foundation objects or not. Usually I'll go to the manage organization pay and job structures tool. Let me go there. And say here you can see I am selecting a legal entity. You see here, I want to create a legal entity. I'm in the manage organization pay and job structures. The moment I click on legal entity, you can see there is a alert message, legal entity has been migrated to MDF. Click here to access legal entity under the MDF foundation objects, which means that this object has been migrated to MDF foundation object. Say when I select locations, see, I don't see that message, which means location is still part of your foundation object coming from your corporate data model. That is how you can, even though if you don't know, you can identify that by going to this manage organization pay and job structure, Samir.
So Raghu, move to the MDF object, because the reason why, because our release is 1508,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah. We'll be working on the 1508 release, as you can see here. So,
Raghu, can you also share the updates that have come in 1508? We don't have access to the partner portal, and it's not online yet.
Pardon, what it is, Samir?
We don't have access to the partner learn portal or any of the portals yet. So I just wanted to see what are the new things in 1508.
Yeah, please. I downloaded that, Samir. I'll be sending out the 1508 release notes probably after the session. Okay, I downloaded that.
Thanks,
yesterday. Yeah. I'll send it to everyone, guys. Don't worry about that. That's not a big deal. But let me continue, guys. So the other entities under your foundation objects are your job function and your basically all these whether an employee is a full-time employment type. I don't need to mention about the fields, guys, the objects here usually, and your pay groups, pay grades, all these things, your pay range, everything goes into your pay component, everything goes into your foundation objects. Okay, and coming to these are part of your foundation objects, and coming to the other type of objects, your employment objects. Your employment objects and the personal object is more of the data related to your employees or the persons in the organization. Okay, and as we are talking about the persons, you can see one of those things is the employment object, another is the personal object. Personal object is more of like things that are closely related to the personal information, the dependent detail, their personal address, all these things goes into your personal objects. Whereas the data that is related to the employee, but they are used to carry out the employee duties in the organization, will go into the employment objects, guys. Okay, and where you are going?
Can you repeat that again?
Yeah, 1 second.
Please, thank you.
So both this personal object related to employee. So both the things are related to employee. The data is going to be related to the employee, but person object is more of like related to the personal information, and they can be anything like what do you call their contact information, employee contact information, their address details, and their biographical information, and whatnot, like the there is
data, birth.
Yeah, data birth, yeah, biographical information, all these things, their emergency contact details, their dependents, so all these things, their work not work permit, guys, all these things are going to be built using your personal object. Whereas coming to the
Raghu, a small request, is it possible you can send these notes to us?
Yeah, that's the reason I'm writing it on, guys. I'll share these notes after the session, okay?
Cool.
Yeah, sure, I'll do that. So employment objects. So your employment objects are related to the employee, but they are specific to the job in the organization, and they are like your employee job information and their employment information, their compensation information, yeah, their hire date and pay components, anything, etc., are all going to be fall under your employment objects. And your generic objects is part of your metadata framework platform, where any sort of custom application can be built, or the custom objects can be built using this generic objects, guys. The reason why they came up with this generic objects, or the reason why they came up, is because they want to get rid of these data models, guys. Because your data models is related to your provisioning account. And you have two systems, right? If you go to your project, you have the one is the instance, the front end, and another is the back end, your provisioning account or the provisioning system. So maintaining these two systems is a tedious job, or it is going to cost for the implementation. And that is the reason you can see a lot of those things has been migrated. Most of the functionality which used to be in the provisioning system is keep on migrating to the instance itself, guys. And one of the such kind of activity is your metadata framework, where initially they just released the metadata framework with the generic objects. But right now you can see all the foundation objects which used to go in your corporate data model XML file, they migrated to generic objects. And with that migration, you don't need to work on the XML files, or you don't need to log into your provisioning system to load the XML file. You can configure those objects using this generic objects metadata framework itself. Okay. These are the four different types of objects that you see across your employee central system, guys. And an example of your generic object is a position, guys. Position is your generic object. It doesn't fall under your either foundation or it doesn't fall under your employment objects. It is a generic object, and your configuration of your generic objects is going to happen from your configure object definition in the administrative tool. And someone might ask you, put your question, guys, where you are going to configure, let's say prior to B1505, where you are going to configure your foundation objects. It is your corporate data model. And where you are going to configure your employment objects, it is your succession data model. Where you are going to configure your personal objects, it is your succession data model. Where you are going to configure your generic objects, it doesn't fall into any of the data models, but you will be configuring that using this configure object definition tool. Okay, and to continue configuring these things, guys, to get familiar. Yeah.
For generic objects, then there is no XML file, right?
Yes, there is no XML file for your generic objects.
Yeah, because it is in the metadata framework. That's why they want to. I think they want to come out of this XML options. That's why.
That is the reason. Like they don't want to go with this XML files or the provisioning system itself, guys. That's the roadmap. I mean, that's the idea behind migrating all these things to your instance. Okay.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah. So what we'll be doing is we'll be following a configuration workbook, guys, with respect to your foundation objects and your employment objects. Let me show you that. This is just a template, guys. I'll show you how to read this configuration workbook, and we'll be carrying out a couple of changes that has been requested with. Let me start with the foundation objects. And you see here, all your foundation object entities has been mentioned here. And this is how your configuration workbook is going to look like, guys. And out of these, you see here, all the changes that the customer is requesting under the legal entity object has been captured in this spreadsheet. And how you are going to read this spreadsheet is, you see the ones that has been mentioned here with the orange color, they are the ones where the customer is requesting a change, guys. Okay, and say external code. So we are in the legal entity object. Okay, we are in the legal entity object. And if you talk about the field with a technical ID of external code, and the standard success factors provided label for that is legal entity ID. And what customer is requesting is, like, there is a change that customer is requesting. You can see under the customer label column, the customer is requesting it should be made to Wheel ID. And this organization ACME is requesting the change. Yes, you can see they are mentioning, yes, they are requesting a change. What the change is, they want to rename the standard success factors provided label for the legal entity ID to Wheel ID.
What is Wheel ID, Raghu?
It's a label. See, usually in SAP, we call it a company code, right? You can see in success factor, they are being called the legal entity ID. Say, if I want to go back to enable editing.
It's just the name of the
that label, whatever we represent on the screen. Let's say okay, I'll show you how it looks like. Let's say this is going to be, so this is my change. And also you can see on the second row, they're calling this legal entity as a wheel. The ones which has been highlighted in this orange color, concentrate on that, guys. Those are the changes. Let's say this is going to be, I want to call it as a company code. Okay. Let's take these three requirements, guys. The one that I just highlighted, the one in the column two, row two, and row five, and row six. So one of the changes, I don't want to call my organization legal entity as legal entity. It should be called as a company code. So where you'd be able to see the legal entity is right now, if you go to your manage data, whenever you're trying to populate the legal entity records or any of the MDF foundation objects records, you go to this manage data and you'll be searching for a legal entity, right? You see here, because right now my organization is using the legal entity as the name to call the company code. Let me click on this legal entity. You see here, everywhere it is being displayed as a legal entity. But I don't want to display it as a legal entity, but I want to display it as a company code in my organization. And here, I don't want to see it as a wheel ID or wheel name. I want to display it as a company code, and it is going to be company name. So how I'm going to do this configuration change is, I have to, this is the requirement. This is how you are going to get the requirement, guys. Let's say, let me take these three requirements here. One is your company code, another is your the legal entity is going to be replaced with company code, and the field name, legal entity ID, is going to be replaced with company code, and the legal entity name is going to be replaced with company name. So how I'll be doing the changes, the configuration changes, I have to go back to your configure object definition, because your legal entity is part of your MDF foundation objects. I have to go to configure object definition. Here, not creating an object. Your legal entity is already available. The object is already available, guys. Search for legal entity. You can see legal entity. Okay. And I want to call the object. You can see the legal entity. I don't want to call it the legal entity. This is the name of your object, but my legal entity should be called as a company code. See here, this is the object name, and I don't want to call it as a legal entity. I want to call it as, my organization wants to call it as a company code. So let me put the company code here. You see here. And the second requirement is, look at the field, the external code field. If you go here, so you can see the external code field. This is the technical database field name, the technical field ID. And if you click on these details, there is a label field, guys. Yeah, you see here, the label. So as per my organization, I want to call it as a company code. Let me put it here. Okay, and if you want to maintain the description in different languages, you can just click on that. You can maintain all these things here, guys. But let me keep it as a English for now. And let me click on done. And the other field that we are interested is the legal entity name, or the name. Name is the technical field ID. Where is the name field? Click on that. You can see, I want to call it as a company company name. So these are the three changes that I did in my configure object definition, which means that in the MDF foundation objects, the legal entity MDF foundation object. Let me save these changes. Just a second, guys. It's taking some time to use. Data source value provided is not a valid. You want to save. Okay, your changes has been saved, right? Now, if you go to, if you want to go and verify these changes, you have to go to your creation of your legal entity. And how you are going to create your legal entity is, go to your manage data. And you want to create a new legal entity. So you can see it is no more called as a legal entity. I am not able to find a legal entity here because we changed that to company code. You see here, I changed my object name, right? I replaced the legal entity object name with a company code. What it is, guys?
So I have one question.
Go ahead, guys.
Yeah. See, when we are changing the titles like this, company code, legal entity as company code, something like that.
Yeah.
So don't we have the standard name? Because when we are going tomorrow, if I am going in a support, and I am searching in a name called VLID, but I am not able to get it. Or somebody has created as a something name called company. Only company they created. They didn't give us company code or company name like that.
Yeah.
So I may be searching few options like company code or something like that. So in that case, if you think I'm not able to track that exactly what they created, so how should we go about it?
No, that is where your configuration workbooks or your organization naming convention is going to be used, Kishore.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. So that is a challenge that until unless if I don't have any accessibility to the documents or something like
exactly.
that.
Exactly. You should know the business, how your organization or how your client is doing the business.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So Raghu, to add to this point, do we have the client gives the business requirement document for
yeah,
this?
Yeah. You are going to prepare this document based on the requirements that you discuss with or gathered from the client. You are going to get a sign off on this configuration workbook, then you are going to start the configuration, actual configuration of the system.
So that means the as per the success factor standard field names, we will get a workbook based on that. We
yeah.
will be working with the client.
Yeah, you can see okay. these are the standard success factors provided label. The C and D columns are there, right? These are the standard
right.
success factors provided. But even you are not handicapped to know these details, you can do a reverse engineering. You can go to the object definition and see what they are calling. You know what is your object, right? If you go to your configure object definition, you will be able to find out what field is each of those things.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a little bit. Like you will be able to do that. Only thing like if you know the business
is
better,
template,
right?
Is these templates are been available from
Success yeah, that is
tools or from?
No, the success factors recommend to use these kind of templates during your project implementation.
Now that's what I'm asking. So where these templates will be available?
You can get it from the partners.successfactors.com. That is one thing where yesterday I downloaded these things, guys. You can see this is how the blank templates are going to look like. You see here, they don't keep anything. They'll just keep it open for you to go ahead and capture the requirements or whatever it may be. You can see all this, your country specific legal entity, business into division, department, cost center, location, everything. They don't capture any requirements. Oh. They just give this kind of templates. And based on the requirements that you gathered from the client, right? You have to go ahead and update this configuration workbook and get a sign off on this and then do the actual configuration on the system.
Got it.
Okay.
So this site which you're telling
is partners.successfactors.com. It's partners.successfactors.com. It will be I'll send this to everyone, guys. Yesterday I send it to a couple of people. partners.successfactors.com. Yeah, this is the.
But Raghu, it is asking username and password. What username and password I give?
I don't know, guys. You have to manage that. I'll not be able to give you. Usually, like if you are a business partner, employee, or if you are already on a project, right, you will be able to get this username and password. You can see this is one portal, and the other portal that I mentioned is the community.successfactors.com. I'll send these details to you guys to just let me come back to the configuration part, guys. I'll send you these details. It's not a big deal. You can see. So let me
one question.
Yep.
Yeah, can you show us once like the portal how it looks, the partner.successfactors.com?
Yeah, I'll show you. Give me a second, guys.
Yeah. because so that if you go to a project, we should know how to.
Even in fact, like I have the screenshots for that. Let me show you. Let me log in here. I'll show you that in a minute. Give me a second, guys. In fact, the same question came up in my previous batch itself. I captured the screenshots of how this looks like. I'll forward that to you, everyone, guys. But let me log in here and I'll show you how it looks like now.
And it shows like how to search, like in that you may have a lot of things. So how to search for
not a lot of things. One is only one search option, but you should know basic navigation where you'll be able to find the documentation part of the configuration workbooks. Those things. If you see here,
and who owns this? Who owns this website?
This is SuccessFactors website.
Okay.
This is maintained by SAP. Yeah, here you can see this is your partners.successfactor.com, guys. You can get all your product details. You can see the product information, the product detail, DTDs, partners, and your methodology, product implementation, methodology, documentation, and all this. Basically, we depend more on this product central. And for project management, you can rely on this methodology. And you have a search option, global search option. And this is the place, guys, where you'll get all these the configuration workbooks, or whatnot, like everything from this place. From this, most of the times, all your support tickets, everything goes here itself, guys. Let's say I can see right now, I am.
I can't see your screen.
Yeah.
You're not able to.
I'm not sharing that one. And you can see under the partner product central, you see all the different products offered by your success factors. And based on the module that you're interested, right, you can just click on one of these. You can see, say, if you're interested in the employee central, click on this employee central, you'll be able to find the release notes or the updates around your employee central. You can see your the one that I downloaded, right, the configuration workbooks from here, guys. Your data models, pick list, and these implementation guides are a little bit old ones, okay? But if you have the contacts, or if you're on a project, right, you can always contact to the support team of SuccessFactors. You can ask them for the latest data models or the any of the support tickets, all these things, guys. I'm closing this thing, guys.
And do you have any user group sort of thing, like we have in SAP?
Not here, but that is in your you can see this is the other thing, right? Community.successfactor.com. This is where you can group, maintain your groups, or it is more of like a developer community where you can raise any sort of questions, like help.sap.com. This is more of like help.sap.com.
Do you have membership?
Yeah, I remember, guys. I created. Yeah, you need to have a user ID and login, and usually, like if you are a partner employee, right, your employer will be able to set up that. But if you are even, I don't know whether the partners will be, the end clients will be able to get, I don't think so, end clients will be able to get to this login, guys. If you are a business partner employee, yes, you will be able to get the login credentials for these things.
Raghu, I have a quick question. This is Nitin. How about this, like, is there any kind of worksheet where they have given, like, how you will map, suppose if you have already implemented SAP HR and then you are going to do an hybrid implementation where you are going to implement, you know, some of the modules of SuccessFactors over and above the existing SAP HR installation. Is there any kind of mapping spreadsheet or something?
Spreadsheet or something, it is goes with your integration add-on, this SAP SuccessFactors integration add-on documentation, Nitin.
Okay.
That will give you like what data is going to, because in your SuccessFactors, all the data migration is going to happen using the CSV files, right? So how the data from your SAP HCM is going to be extracted into these CSV files, which can be straight away consumed by your SuccessFactors, is going to be done by your SuccessFactor integration add-on that goes on your SAP R3 system, Nitin.
Thanks, Raghu. So basically, if the new implementation, like, you know, the SuccessFactor, then, because what I was thinking is, like, we have already have the personal area, sub area, employee groups and subgroups, and now if we have to implement SuccessFactors over and above that, how will I map my personal area?
And you don't need to map that manually, because if the moment you are using, especially if you are using your SAP R3, right? The advantage with that is the integration add-on. You don't need to write a single program to extract your data or do the mapping. SuccessFactors or the SAP SuccessFactors already did that mapping in the integration add-on, and that those programs, that those reports will help you to extract the data.
Okay. So that will read my objects.
Exactly,
in
your
SAP
input type.
No, but if there is a custom object which I have written in SAP, then how it will map to
your custom object doesn't supported by your SAP SF integration add-on, and you should have a custom object again in your SuccessFactors as well, right?
Right.
Then it is our responsibility or the consultant's duty to migrate the data. Again, if you have a custom object in your employee central, all your custom objects goes part of your generic objects. You can extract the data from your generic objects, or you can import the data into your generic objects again from the CSV files itself, Nitin. So you have the flexibility from SuccessFactors side, you have the flexibility. Again, on the other side, for your SAP R3, you need to have a custom report being developed for that to extract the data.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. So let me come back to the...
Raghu, this is Rajiv. Listen, I had an internet problem, so can you send the recording for today and yesterday, please?
Yesterday, I need to look into it yesterday, Rajiv. But let me convert this and I'll share that with you, Rajiv.
Thank you so much.
Oh yeah, sure. Let me come back, guys. Give me some time if you have any just questions. Just hold on for another 10-15 minutes. Yeah. Go ahead, guys.
Srihari here.
Yes, Srihari.
Hello.
Yeah, tell me, Srihari.
Raghu, I joined a meeting late. Can I send me the recording for today?
Yeah. Just drop me an email, guys. If you have any problem, right? Just drop me an email. I'll be able to help you out, guys. Yeah, no worries. I just started recording, guys, in between. I didn't start it from starting. I started in between. I even forgot to start recording from the starting onwards. But let me convert that and I'll share, Srihari. Just drop me an email, Srihari. Or let me take a note. 1 second, Srihari.
Sure.
Yeah.
Raghu, same here. I have connected late. So I will drop your email.
Okay. And guys, if you are not able to attend, just let me know before itself. Because if I am not able to record that, right, I'll not be able to help you out, guys.
No, actually, I was working on some other link. And then I realized this is the new
link. Okay, I'm just telling like all the sessions going forward. So let me continue with this configuration work, because let me complete at least one or two objects for today, and then I'll leave it to you to go ahead and configure other things, guys. Let's say they have another, you see here right now, let me take another requirement where, not here, guys. Okay. Let me come back to the business unit, guys. So we know how to change your labels or the object names now. So let me come to business unit, another entity. And here you can see one of the requirement. If you take this requirement that has been mentioned in the row 6. The requirement that they mentioned is the SuccessFactors provided name is business unit name. And they want to label it as a customer label as hub name, and the required property, they want to make this field as a mandatory field. The standard field might be a optional field, guys, but the customer is requesting make this business unit name on the business unit entity as a mandatory field. Let me show you how the current business unit is looks like, and then we will go ahead and configure that, guys. Manage.
Raghu, why the workbook name is not changed?
Workbook name not changed.
like there is a legal
no,
entity.
No, no. Let me tell you, your MDF foundation objects workbook is not at release. They are still following the same workbook. I even searched for that. Even I searched my project portal also. They don't have a configuration workbook yet for your MDF foundation objects. Still, they are using the same thing. And even you can see these templates I downloaded yesterday only.
Okay.
Have the same legal entity name only. Yeah, business unit, right? We are in the business unit. So we want to create a new right now. How your business unit looks like is you see here, they already changed this hub name, and you can see the business unit is named as business unit. Okay, hub name is made as a mandatory. How the standard looks like is this hub name is not a mandatory field. Let's say I want to make it as an optional field. How I'm going to make it as an optional field and how the business unit should be called as a hub is you go to your I'm doing this reverse engineering, guys. I want to make it as a right now it is being named as hub name. I want to name it as a business unit name. And you can see I want to call it as a business unit as a hub here. So how I'm going to change that required property is you have to go to again configure object definitions, guys. Your object definition needs to be changed for that. Go to your object definition, configure object definitions. And we are interested in changing the properties of your object called as a business unit. Search for the identify the business unit object. This is your business unit object, and I want to do a couple of changes here. Let me hub, let me state it as hub, and the other change that the customer is requesting is go to your external name. Here you can see they want to name it as a hub name. It's already changed, guys. I'm just showing you here, but it is pretty simple. Earlier it used to call it the business unit name. It used to be like this, guys. So whenever the customer is requesting, it should be called as a hub name. I'm going to change it the label as a hub name, and the property around your hub name, you see here the required mandatory property is going to be maintained like this. By default it is going to be no, guys, which is not, which means that it's not a mandatory field. So let me make it as not a mandatory field, and let me click on done. Let me save these changes. Just a second.
Raghu, can you show me that property again, please?
Yeah, I'll show you. I'll come back here in a minute, Paresh. Just give me a second. I will go ahead and change that property again, Paresh. Give me a second. Let me show you how the system, how the business unit looks like now with these kind of properties. Okay. Now your object definition has been changed, right? Let me go back to my managed data. If I want to create a new business unit, I'll go to manage data. And I want to create a new business unit. You can see I don't find a business unit here. I have to search with hub. Search with hub, and you see the hub name is no more a mandatory because we removed the property associated with your hub name field from required. Earlier the required attribute is set to yes, and we renamed that, we changed it to no, which is means that it's an optional field. And you see earlier it used to be a business, the object name is business unit, and we changed it to hub. That is the reason you can see everywhere it is being named as a hub. Say now I am going to implement this requirement. As per my client requirement, I want to make this hub name, the business unit name field, as a mandatory field. That field should be a mandatory. You see here, the required property of your field should be set to S. So for that, I go to the object definition. I'll go to the property of that field, guys. To navigate to the property of that particular field, go to the object. Your object can be accessed using your configure object definitions. Okay, and your object definition, and the one that we are interested is the hub. Okay, and click on make correction. Here your external name, click on this details. Okay, and here the property is the required. You can see the required is the property that we need to change. Click on from no to yes, guys. Click on this done. Save these changes. Okay, and now if I go back to the, if I want to create a new business unit in my organization or my SuccessFactors instance, I go to the manage data option, click on this manage data. And I want to create a new business unit called, which is renamed to hub. And now you can see the hub is made as mandatory. Let's say it is going to be AS underscore goods manufacturing unit, and so if I want to save my business unit without populating the hub name, I'll not be able to do that. Let me show you guys. You can see hub name is a mandatory field, is a required field. So your hub name, we change it to mandatory, right? We made it as a required field. So now if I go to and click on save, and there is a workflow associated behind this, and you need an approval from your group. Talent approval group, all these group guys. Okay, you can just submit it. I'll show you how to approve this. Okay, we'll work on this the complete approval the workflow process, guys. How to configure your workflows, how to write your business rules, and how to approve that. Okay, see, it is pending for approval. Okay. So that is how you are going to do these sort of changes, guys. What I recommend to you is go ahead. I know, like, still I have to grant you access for a couple of people. I am doing it. And what I recommend to you, if you already have access, go ahead and do the changes that has been mentioned here in this configuration workbook for your legal entity, business unit, division, location. I'm going to explain you how you are going to do it, because your location is still part of your corporate data model or the foundation objects, corporate data model, XML file. So I'll show you how to do these changes. Do only the legal entity, business unit, division, guys. We'll carry out the rest of those things in tomorrow's session. Associations I haven't discussed yet, but I'll talk about that probably in tomorrow's session or day after tomorrow. But do the changes till legal entity, business unit, division, guys. Okay, guys. Any questions, guys?
Raghu, you will be sending the configuration workbook.
I might have already shared this in your. Okay, I'll resend this the template and this configuration workbook to everyone, guys. Again.
And also the recording, Raghu, please.
Okay, Raju, you already have the access to the e-learning portal, right? You can find that. I'll be loading yesterday's and today's session in the e-learning portal. Rajiv,
oh, you will be loading it.
Yeah, I'll be loading. I need some time, probably by my time tomorrow morning I'll be able to load. Rajiv,
Okay.
Raghu, we tried yesterday, like I was not able to access that the e-learning portal. It was giving some error, you know.
Yeah. Chandra, I'll write an email to you, Chandra. That's what I'm talking when I started the session, right? All the your access has been revoked to your e-learning portal. I'll talk to you on that, Chandra.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
Raghu,
can you
please have
the access?
You see, this EC access, yeah, EC access and material I'll share with you, Nitin. I'll do that. Nitin, yes. I need
EC server access details also, right?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks.
Samir, can you give me a call, Samir?
Yeah, I can. I'll just give you a call.
Okay, sure.
Raghu, are we?
Paresh. Tell me, Paresh.
Raghu?
Yes, Mita.
Raghu, I do not have this EC access.
No, I'll set up that and share with you, Smita. Just give me some time till just hold. Probably I'll be able to send you out the access by tomorrow class time, Smita, for everyone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Raghu, I sent you the email.
Yeah, okay, Sunil. I'll look into it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Raghu.
Raghu, I was asking that are we having a class in a weekend? That was I was asking.
No, not this weekend, Paresh. No, I'm not able to hear you that, Paresh. But not this weekend, Paresh. We'll have session for tomorrow. But on Saturday, Sunday, I don't think so I'll be able to take. I'll confirm you tomorrow, Paresh. Is that fine? Most 99% I'll not be able to take session for this weekend.
Yeah, okay.
But if something changes on my side, right, definitely I'm interested to take a session on one of the weekend, either this weekend or next weekend.
Okay.
Yeah, sure, guys.
Fine.
Yeah.
Okay. I also sent you a email. Please look at it.
Oh, yeah, sure, Rajiv.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thanks, Raghu.
Yep. Okay, guys. Thanks, guys. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.